We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Discover Newport. Chef John Bach-Sorensen is here. Asterisk Restaurant is the place. We're making crispy salmon with mushroom, orzo, and red wine sauce. Thanks for coming in today.
Thank you so much.
Great to have you here. Now, this is a perfect summertime recipe. We've got the wine. We have the fresh fish.
Fish, yes. Let's go over some asparagus.
Yeah, let's go over some
mushrooms.
Of the ingredients.
And this morning I picked up some nice wild. Cilantro and some tarragon and some arugula and toasted some orzo off, so to make that nice risotto we're going to see.
Now, you and I were talking, you know, before we went on the air today about recipes that you like to put together. You always like to create something with different tastes, but also something that people at home, if they have the recipe, it's easy for them to make, correct?
Well, I believe it's keep it simple, because as life is getting more hectic, it's better to get some really, really good ingredients and then start from there. And don't really do too much to it. Just let it all be itself.
And all the ingredients that you have today, are they local stuff? Is it fresh stuff from around New England or Rhode Island?
Everything is from New England. So as the season going into it right now, we're getting asparagus from New Jersey. And as the season coming closer to us, so the tomatoes from New Jersey, asparagus from New Jersey, mushrooms from New, I mean, those are just probably hothouse mushrooms, but all the herbs are from my yard, and so, yeah.
And these are all recipes that are easy to make,
yes.
Served in your restaurant all the time. And you've been cooking for a long time, too, right?
Quite a while, yes. Over 30 years.
And how long at the restaurant?
16 years.
16 years. Very nice. And what's the specialty at the restaurant?
It is actually the crispy salmon we're showing right now, which has been actually for the first day on the menu.
Really? And yes. Newport will be a very busy place. This will be the number one thing on the restaurant.
I hope so.
So you better stock up on this salmon. All right, perfect.
Thank you. We have
our ingredients ready to go. We're going to get cooking next segment. And we're going to be using this wine, too, to be cooking, too. Back to you. It's going very well. We are back in the kitchen this morning. Discover Newport. Chef John Bach-Sorensen is here from Asterisk Restaurant, and he said he's going to show me how to cook. We're going to make orzo now,
yes,
right?
Yes, we are. Yes, we have
our sleeves rolled up.
Yes.
So when you have your sleeves rolled up, you know something good's going to happen.
You're going to start.
We're going to start. Okay.
What are we going to do first? We're going to start bring the little heat to the pan here.
Okay. So now, what do we put in this? Was this just
this is a little olive oil and a little butter.
Okay.
So we're just waiting for the butter to just get a little bit warmer.
And I want to ask you why both. I mean, you know, if some people come in and just put the oil in there. Why both?
First of all, oil is good.
Right,
olive oil is good.
Mm-hmm.
But second of all is that when you put oil in a pan and put butter afterwards, then actually it holds down the butter so it doesn't burn.
Oh, really?
So
okay.
It's just, you know, but you still have to really look at the pan and
right.
make sure it's getting
right.
done. So let's just put these in the mushrooms.
Okay.
So there's mushrooms with a little bit of Vidalia onions, because Vidalia onions is right now in season, and then a little garlic and some asparagus. And then we're just going to...
All finely chopped up, except the mushrooms.
It's called mirepoix, and then sliced the mushrooms. And then we're going to put some toasted orzo, which is like just an orzo we just put in the pan and put it in the oven for about 20 minutes, 15, 20 minutes, so it gets a little toasty and it gets a little nutty flavor.
Right, and orzo always has a great flavor. I mean, even if you weren't to add this to it, orzo just with a meal is always great.
Well, actually, this recipe comes from, as long as I've been doing it, it comes from a Spanish recipe, which was actually served with wild boar sausage.
Oh, really?
And
okay.
You know, like try to really bring it up and make it a little bit more summery.
Just mix it up. Yes. Right.
So we're going to put this in here too.
Cook that.
Yeah. And it's actually easy, because you just let it just simmer a little bit.
And all simple ingredients that can be whipped up pretty quick,
yes,
too.
Yes, yes, yes.
Very good.
I mean, just put it right in one pan and off you go.
All right. And how long should this
simmer? It's going to take a few minutes.
When you can see
that it gets a little bit light here.
Right.
Like so.
And then we're done.
Yeah.
All right. Perfect. All right.
Then we're going to put a little cream on it.
All right.
Here you go.
Do a little cream and we are good to go.
All
right. Thank you, Chef.
You're welcome.
We have the orzo cooking away. We'll be back in just a little bit with
good.
More. Back to you.
We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, cooking with Discover Newport and Chef John from Asterisk Restaurant, and we are about to cook our salmon.
Yes, we are. We got to put it right in here. The oil is warm and
heat
it up, so we're just going to take it.
Have you seasoned this at all?
Yes, I have. I put a little salt and pepper on it.
Okay.
Oh, see, it's sizzling.
That's what we know it's hot.
So we do it skin side up, and then we're just going to sit it there and just crispy up and be beautiful.
Now, what's the reason for skin side up?
Well, it's just it's the last thing you actually, the first thing you cook, but it's the last thing you actually see. So you want to really, it's sort of like a,
it's just how it's done. I shouldn't have even questioned it. That's just how it's done.
You just have to trust me.
And you can see that cooking up quick.
Yes.
The total change of color there.
Yes. Actually, there's a little trick. If you want to go a little bit faster, you just take a little lid on top, and then just like just sits there and sizzle. You don't get all these flats, and it's perfect. Yeah.
How long will it take to?
It's going to take about 3-4 minutes, and it'll be perfect.
Yeah. And we are going to pair that with our orzo over here. Remind everyone at home what went into this.
Well, that's it has a little Vidalia onions and sautéed mushrooms and asparagus, and then sautéed off and a little garlic, and then I put cream in it, and finish it up with some tarragon and salt and pepper.
And that cream is really creating just a different texture.
Yes,
but it's kind of holding everything, binding it together.
Yeah, it's like an orzo.
it's like orzo.
But then it's a risotto. It's just a different way of using it to it, and it gives texture. Actually, when you taste it, this you can actually just get some nutty flavor with the red wine sauce, actually, which we have right here.
Okay.
I'm just going to put some of this Pinot Noir in here. It's the red wine sauce that we're going to use for the dish, and it's very, very good.
What else is in here?
It's a reduction. No, it's actually beef stock, and then we saute onions and garlic and carrots and celery, and we let it caramelize a lot, and then we put a little bit of red wine vinegar and red wine, a lot of red wine. Yeah, yes. And then we
don't skimp on that, right?
And then the beef stock on top, and then just cook it down, and then we end up, we put a little bit of butter in it and salt and pepper, and then we actually, we put some spices in there, like sometimes we put a little bit of cinnamon and nutmeg and, you know, just to flavor it up.
Whatever you feel like doing that day.
Sadly. No, we're going to turn this one before
you see?
And there you go.
Wow.
I'll turn down.
Fizzle it away.
Yeah, we'll turn down the heat a little bit and then it will be done very soon.
That has great color to it.
Thank you. It is what it is.
And the flavors must pair so well together, fish and the orzo with the mushrooms and the vegetables.
Yes, you know, the funny thing is about this dish, it's actually, it's even as good in the wintertime as it is in the summertime.
So and, it's all year round.
And you know, with a nice Pinot Noir as this here, put a little bit in a cooler and it's nice. It's just like, and you know.
A great summertime.
The next day, if you have a little bit left over, put it into your sangria. Beautiful. You
know, good ideas for the whole week at this point. And you're offering this dish at your restaurant,
yes,
right?
Yes, we do. Yes. It's one of the staples. It's been on the menu since the first day we opened the restaurant, so 16 years.
Wow. Yeah. And you're going to plate this up for us
right? Yes.
So here's, I'll leave that to you.
Okay.
And you know what? You can plate and I'll just relax with my glass of wine right
here. That's what we like. That's why you come to a restaurant. That's, we do the job and
just sit back and relax.
You just hang out and have a good time.
This is delicious.
Thank you.
We've got the orzo going on the plate. We've got our salmon about to go on as well. I don't know if you want to take a look at this over here. You already plated one up. It just looks fabulous. You know what? I think I'm going to have to try it.
Good. Well, we're going to put a little bit of a red wine sauce on this one here.
Mm-hmm.
Cheat a little bit here. There you go.
Get some sauce in there. Little bit of everything.
Good.
Here we go.
Just do a little bit of asparagus. And then we can garnish with a little bit of our fresh herbs and our salads here. Actually, you know, you can be very creative when you do this
because,
you know, it's not every day you can change it. You know, like you got all these beautiful herbs and lettuce and all that. So,
have
you know,
some creative
fun. If you don't want too many starches, you just put a little bit things on it.
It's all right. Good. Well, you're going to finish plating that. Don't forget, you can find the recipes to all of these elements on our website, WPRI.com.
Yes. Thank you.